Welcome to another Selfish OS podcast, and this time around I'm showing you a nice possibility how to install a third-party client for installing applications on Selfish OS, and this is called Storeman, and it looks basically just like the Yola Store, maybe slightly bit different, but it has a lot of experimental applications, a lot of testing applications, beta applications even, and other applications that are not allowed into the Yola store because they're using experimental APIs and so on. So how can you get this version of the store? So first of all, if you install your Selfish X or Selfish S, what you need to do is just go into settings and then enable the installing of untrusted software, and you have to mark it here so it is enabled, and then you can open up your browser and go to the website openrepos.net, and then you are able to just simply go in here and search for the Storeman application. Why is this search not working? Now it's working. I have to search for the Storeman application, and then you will find search results, and I think the first search result is the right one, the correct one, as you don't have a Turing phone probably. And then you have to just simply scroll a bit down and you will see links here. Scroll to the bottom, as the bottom has the newest version, and then search for the version that you want to install. Let me make this a little bigger. There are usually two versions, the ARM V7HL version and an i486. And what you want to have for most devices, just like for the Gemini PDA, for Sony Xperia XA2, for the Sony Xperia X device, for example, what you want to have is most of the time the ARM V7HL. You click on this. It will say it will download it, the file, and after it downloaded the file, you can click on the file in the download manager and then say install. I don't have to do this right now, as I've already installed it. After installation is done, you can find the application in your application drawer, and you can just simply start it. It will take a little bit longer, as it is, I think, adding the default repository for Storeman itself, so it can update itself, which is, I think, a nice addition, and then it will keep itself updated. Otherwise, the way it works is just, as you can see, here's the Storeman application. The way it works is that if you click on application, you can see, of course, screenshots, you can see the description of the application, you have the option to see the change log, so what has changed in the new version, update translation in this case. You can see comments, you have the option to comment, of course, you can see tags and you can see more of this user, because every user can upload applications here into and gets its own repository. So if you want to install a new application, what you need to do, just like, let's go to Sale Reads. I don't know what this is. It's a book application, reading application for Goodreads. If I want to install it now, because it's not installed, as you can see here, I have to go and say add this repository by this user. I don't have anything else by this user installed, so I have the option here to add this repository. If I add this repository, it will just simply add all the applications this user has produced into the available state for the operating system, basically. It will then, after it added the repository, take a few seconds to reload, refresh the list of applications that are available. And then you have the option to install this application just by dropping down and then saying install. As you can see here, here's an indicator that says it's installing and it's already installed. Then after installation, of course, I can find in the app drawer and there's Sailreads. I can open it up and yeah, welcome to Sailreads. So this is how installation of applications work. The same way, if you don't like this application, you want to remove the application, you have the option to just simply remove the application from here. But if you like the application, give it a star, give it a thumbs up, give it a nice comment, give suggestions if you find bugs and so on, what to make better, or if you find bugs, give bug reports and so on. Most of the applications also support or have an GitHub address or some other source address where you can find the source, where you can report bugs and donate as well. As you can see here, you have also the option to donate money to applications. So in this case, if you want to remove an application, just hit remove in here and this application will be removed. What will not be removed is the repository itself. So you will still get notifications, for example, if this user would also upload a fork of some applications that you have installed, you will get a notification that there's an update available for this application. So if you don't want this, you cannot remove this from here. What you have to do is go back and you have this repositories option here where you can see the various different repositories. And then, how was the user called? Forgot already. It's Maledictus. If you want to remove the Maledictus repository, you have to go in here, and it's just an example. It's not that it's a bad app. Also, you can disable this repository, you can refresh it again, or you can remove it. And yeah, you can remove it if you don't like this repository at all or something like this. Especially useful if you have some dev repositories enabled or something like this that will override your packages, which is not desired, I would say. So this is one way to deal with repositories. Of course, you can see all the repositories here that are enabled, but there will be a category for disabled repositories as well. And of course, you can remove all or disable all or refresh all, refresh the cache for all of those repositories. Then if you want to have an overview of all installed applications, you can click on this here, which will give you an overview of all installed applications. And it has a double role. If you have updates for applications pending, it will list the updates on top here for the applications that you have installed. This is also, I think, fine. If you have local RPM files that you've downloaded manually for openrepos.com, .net, for example, you can list them here in local RPM files, which will search the file system for local RPM files. And as you can see, you have a development version of WebKit and Video Player installed, for example, and some other RPMs that you've found here lying on my system, just like Qt WebKit, new version of Qt WebKit. Of course, you have the option to bookmark certain applications. If you have a favorite list or want to make a favorite list of your favorite top 10 applications and you want to just simply tell other people that are new to Sailfish.js, these are the applications that you need. You have the option to, or these are the applications from open repos that you need. You can just simply bookmark those applications and you have a nice list of favorite applications. Of course, you have the option to go to categories and search for different applications and not only show the newest applications. And as you can see, you can search by different categories. Just like, for example, I'm searching for music application. I can see there's Hotspot. And if I want to install this Spotify client, I can just simply download the Spotify client. In this case, there are sometimes even notifications or sometimes even stuff in here. Those are experimental apps sometimes. And in this case, read the docs before downloading. So it's very important to read the docs. As you can see here, for this to run, you need also to install LibreSpot, which is a dependency. And not all the applications in here have fixed dependencies, so they will automatically download stuff. Most of them do, but not all of them will do. So reading the notifications, reading the description of the application makes a lot of sense in contrast to maybe the Yola store where basically everything is running without any problems. If you want to install an application here from the music category, you can also, without going into the description, press and hold. Usually It's not working. Usually I would expect that you can just press and hold and then say install. In this case, it's not working, but you can give it a star, which is working, and add it to your bookmarks in this case if you give it a star. So there are also a patches category if you want to install patches. I would recommend using the patch manager for this and not installing RPM patches, but yeah, you're free to do everything that you like with this store. So it's a store for advanced users, I would say. You can find very nice applications on here that are not allowed in the hardware store. But yeah, be a little bit careful also that the quality may vary on this store, especially with utilities that are command line utilities or libraries that are there that also override the default libraries shipped by the operating system. This might all vary in terms of quality and compatibility, especially when updates happen. So it is recommended to disable all those, and there's a nice option in repositories, you can just simply say disable all, to disable all of them before upgrading, doing a system upgrade if a new SafeHS version arrives. So this is a short introduction into open repos and the Storeman client, and also some tips and tricks how to deal with installing applications and what's important if you want to upgrade from one SafeHS version to another version. Usually I don't disable those, and I didn't have had any big problems with any of those repositories so far, but there are reports with certain repositories that, especially those that override the default libraries of SafeJS, that SafeJS usually ships, that there might occur some problems, and it's recommended to disable this. So this is a safe step. If you want to be ultra safe, just disable all the repositories before doing a system upgrade. This is everything for this little demonstration. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and until the next time. Bye.